In continuation with chapter number 5, that is magnetism and matter, let's study another topic, magnetic poles of an electromagnet. Let's find the magnetic poles of an electromagnet. We have studied in our previous lecture about electromagnet, and we also know that a bar magnet behaves like a solenoid. We have studied their magnetic field lines in the previous lecture. Now, we also know that bar magnet has two poles. Thus, if bar magnet is similar to solenoid, then it must be having two poles. So if we would like to determine these poles, let's draw one diagram. This is a soft iron cylinder in which the current is flowing through a coil. And the direction of current is in this way. This is an electromagnet now, or a current carrying solenoid, we can consider it. So here, if we want to find that which end is acting as a south pole or which end is acting as a north pole, consider this side. At this side, if we see and bring near to this magnet one magnetic needle, and this needle is facing, its north pole is facing towards this end. Now, when we will see or observe the direction of current, then this direction is anticlockwise, and this needle, when come closer to this electromagnet, will deflect to 180 degree. It shows that this anti-clockwise direction or this end acts as a north pole. Thus, when the current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction, then that end behaving like a north pole, and we come to know about this pole by bringing a magnetic needle near to this end. Similarly, if we will reverse the direction of current, then, and if we observe at this end and bring closer a magnetic needle facing south, then the magnetic needle will rotate or deflect up to 180 degree. This shows that when the current is flowing in clockwise direction, the end, this end will behave like a south pole. एंड वी नो दैट द नॉर्थ पोल, इफ यू नीड टू रिमेंबर ओनली वन डायरेक्शन, दैट इज ऑल्सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट नॉर्थ पोल इज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. Now, as we have studied earlier, that the electric force on a charge in the presence of electric field, the force experienced by charge is given as Q into E. And if this charge is positive, we know that the force experienced by the positive charge in a uniform electric field is QE, and its direction is towards the electric field. Its direction is the direction of electric field. And when the charge is negative, its direction is opposite to the direction of electric field. Similarly, the magnetic force experienced by the pole is, when we are considering it as a north pole, and the north pole is experiencing a force in the direction of magnetic field. Thus, we can compare the north pole as a positive charge. And the south pole experiencing the force in the opposite direction of magnetic field. So remember this also. North pole is anti-clockwise and south pole is clockwise. Positive as a north pole. Its direction is along the direction of magnetic field. Now next topic is current carrying circular loop also behaves like a bar magnet. We have studied in our previous lecture that bar magnet behaves like a current carrying solenoid. Now see a circular loop in which the current is flowing, suppose in this direction. When the current flows through this circular loop, the magnetic field will be produced around it. And the direction of magnetic field, according to right hand thumb rule, we can see that in this case, it is out of the plane of a paper. So, we can draw it in this manner. Thus, a current carrying circular loop behaves like a magnet because it has its own magnetic field. Now, if we want to determine that if it is a current carrying loop and if it is a magnet, then it has two poles. So if we want to determine these poles, then if we will look it at the upper end of this circular loop, then the current flowing in this circular loop direction will be anti-clockwise. This gives that the upper side of this circular loop is behaving as a north pole, and the lower end is behaving like a south pole, because when we will see through the lower end, then the current looks like flowing in the direction anti-clockwise, in the clockwise direction. Thus, the direction in the inner side is from south to north, and outside it is from north to south. And if we will compare the magnetic field lines of this circular loop with the magnetic field lines of a bar magnet, then let us suppose it is the north pole of a magnet and this is the south pole of a magnet. Then the magnetic field lines are traveling from south to north inside the magnet, and it is emerging out from the magnet from north pole and merging into the south pole. So these are the continuous closed curves formed by a bar magnet, which is similar to the magnetic field lines formed by a circular loop. The magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron for this, let's consider an atom having nucleus, and let us suppose in an orbit one electron is revolving around it. It is having radius r and its direction is let this way. Electron is moving in this way, and as the electron is moving, it has some angular velocity, that is omega, and when the electron revolves around the nucleus, it constitutes current, which is having direction opposite to the direction of electron. Now here we are finding the value of magnetic dipole moment when the electron revolves around the nucleus. For this, as we have studied in the previous chapter, the value of magnetic dipole moment is equal to NIA, where N is the number of turns and current, and this is area vector. Whatever be the direction of area vector is the direction of magnetic dipole moment. Here, in order to find the value of magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron, we will denote this magnetic dipole moment by म्यू, एंड इट इज नोन एज ऑर्बिटल मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल मोमेंट. Here the direction of area vector is vertically upwards, thus the direction of orbital magnetic dipole moment is vertically upwards, and the direction of angular momentum is vertically downwards. How? Let's see it. As we know that the direction of area vector is perpendicular to the plane of a paper. It can be vertically outward or it can be vertically downward. But here in our case, when the electron is flowing in this direction, thus the direction of current is opposite to this. And when we will apply right hand thumb rule, we see that the encircled fingers gives the direction of current. Then the thumb in which the direction in which the thumb advances gives the direction of area vector. So here the direction of area vector is vertically upward. So is the direction of magnetic dipole moment. Now to understand the direction of angular momentum, let's understand that angular momentum is given as L equivalent to the position vector, that is the distance with direction, and the momentum, linear momentum. The direction of linear momentum depends on the direction of velocity. So here the direction of velocity is tangential. As the electron is moving in this direction, so here the direction of velocity is in this way. This is the direction of velocity, and the direction of position vector is radially outward, starts from the origin to the orbit, different positions. So here R is the position vector having this direction, and we know that when we are talking about circle, so the tangent drawn at a circle, the angle which the tangent makes with the radius is 90 degree. Tangent and R is making an angle of 90 degree here. Now to find the direction of angular momentum, we have to shift this P, direction of P, to this end. It will not make any difference. Now here also it is making an angle of 90 degree, because here we are dealing with cross product. So the tail of the two vectors should meet to find the direction of the third vector. So here it is R vector, or it is P vector. This is the direction of linear momentum. Now by right hand screw rule, if the screw is moving in this way, that is R cross P, R is moving towards P, then where the thumb advances or the screw advances gives the direction of angular momentum. So here the screw is advancing in vertically downward direction. Thus we can say that the direction of angular momentum is vertically downward. So this is about angular momentum. Now magnitude of orbital magnetic dipole moment is given as mu L equivalent to as one electron is revolving in an orbit. So here we are taking one. Current is given as charge by unit time, that is here charge is electron by time. Here area, magnitude of area vector is area of completing square. It can be written as E into nu, 1 by T is nu, frequency, into pi r square. And in terms of angular velocity, omega can be written as 2 pi nu. Therefore, we can say nu equivalent to omega by 2 pi. Thus, mu L equal to E into omega by 2 pi into pi r square. Pi will be cancelled out, and here we remain with omega into E r square by 2. Now in this equation, multiply and divide by the mass of electron. We will get mu L equal to, write it in this way, E upon 2 mass of electron into mass of electron r square omega. Now here this value m r square omega equivalent to or angular momentum. So write E by 2 m E into L. And in magnitude form, if we will write, then we get mu L vector equal to E upon 2 m E minus L vector. Here minus sign indicates that the direction of orbital magnetic moment is opposite to the direction of angular momentum of an electron. So this is the value of magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron. Now if we will take a ratio of orbital magnetic dipole moment to angular momentum of an electron, then it is equivalent to a constant, that is E upon 2 ME. And when we will substitute its value, that is electron, charge of an electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulomb by 2 into 9.1 into 10 raised to the power -31 kg. And when we will solve it, we get a constant equal to 8.8 × 10⁻¹⁰ coulomb per kg. This constant is known as gyromagnetic constant. Thus, the ratio of orbital magnetic dipole moment to the angular momentum of an electron, the ratio of it is known as gyromagnetic ratio, and it gives a constant which is equal to 8.8 × 10⁻¹⁰ coulomb per kg. According to Bohr's hypothesis, when an electron revolves around a nucleus, then the angular momentum produced by it because of its mass, radius and the velocity, L=mvr, and the angular momentum is an integral multiple of h upon 2π, where h is a Planck's constant. Thus, we will calculate the value of orbital magnetic dipole moment for one electron. That is the minimum magnetic dipole moment we can find by substituting the value of angular momentum in this formula. Thus, we will get minimum orbital magnetic dipole moment. Here n is number of orbits. Thus mu l minimum can be written as nh, here n is 1, h upon 2π into e upon 2me. Substitute the value of all constants, we get Planck's constant is given by 6.63 × 10⁻¹⁴ × 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ is the charge of electron, 4 × 3.14 × mass of electron is 9.1 × 10⁻¹⁹. And when we will solve these values, we get 9.27 × 10⁻¹⁴, and the SI unit of orbital magnetic dipole moment is ampere into meter square, and this is known as Bohr's magneton. This value That is, Bohr magneton can be defined as as the orbital magnetic moment of an electron revolving in the innermost orbit of atom. So this is all for today. Thank you.